was with God. Welcome to God's Word right here on EagleM Ministries International Church online, and also to our www.facebook.com/EagleM International Church channel, and also our Virgil Taylor YouTube channel. Praise God, you guys have taken our time to log on to the broadcast on today. We have powerful broadcast on today. We also had an opportunity to actually have our communion. So, and those of you all who want to take communion with us, I know that you do it, because I got a Facebook message in from one of the brothers there in Uganda the other day. Said, Pastor Virgil, we were taking communion with you. So we praise God. Anyone who wants to do it, we're fine with that. We're fine with that. Well, we got a powerful service on today. We're going to have our First Lady. Actually, our First Lady actually was our MC on today. First Lady India Taylor, we praise God for her on today. And we had our opening prayer by Evangelist Malagros. And our scripture reading was Psalms 30 and 5, Nehemiah 8 and 10 by Evangelist Donzie Cepeda. And then we gave you two praise and worship videos. Actually, one praise and worship video, Here Am I to Worship, and also our sermonic music video, Healing by the Maestro. I want to say pastor. Maybe I'm taking them to a different level. Reverend Richard Smallwood. Amen. Amen. And then we came back with the word on today. So we want you to enjoy what God has for you on today. God bless you.
Praise the Lord, everyone.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
First, we will have opening prayer by Evangelist Malagros, followed by a scripture, Psalms 35 and Nehemiah 8 and 10 by Evangelist Donzie Cepeda. And then we will have two videos.
You don't have to give the whole thing.
Followed by our sermon and then communion. Another video and then communion service. In that order. Evangelist Malagros.
It's a delight. She didn't hear you. Talk again.
Hello, let us pray. Let us begin now, Father.
Hallelujah.
Almighty and loving Father, creator of heaven and earth, we praise and adore you, Father God. You are the King of Kings. We humbly ask your forgiveness for our sins. Yes. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Send your Holy Spirit to be our guide and give us the wisdom to understand every word that we are going to hear. Enlighten our minds and let your love be upon us. May this meeting bring success and we grow more for our spiritual life. We thank you, Father, for this precious time that you have given to us.
Yes.
Bless us. Bless our pastor and each and every one of us, Father God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Amen. Evangelist Darcy.
We're starting with scripture Psalms 30 and 5. It reads as follows. For his anger endureth but a moment, and his favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy is come in the morning. Now we're going to turn to Nehemiah 8 and 10. It reads as follows. Then he said unto them, Go your way, eat the fat, and drink the sweet, and send portions unto them for whom nothing is prepared. For this day is holy unto our Lord. Neither be ye sorry, for the joy of the Lord is your strength.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Light of
I'm there. times this happens to me, but the Lord gave me this song in a dream. And when I woke up, I knew that was a healing song. And I knew that God had ordained that because I was going through some spiritual pain of my own. And it was speaking to my soul. I just wanted to encourage other people who might be going through pain that God is a healer. Earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. There's no situation that you're going through that's so difficult that God cannot fix it. I don't care what your friends say. I don't care what your family says. I don't care what whoever's around you says. There's healing. For your soul and for your spirit. So we want you to be encouraged tonight. And not be discouraged. Joy comes in the morning.
Joy comes in the morning.
Know that God is nigh. Don't try to fight the battle yourself, but stand still and look up. God is going to show up.
God is going to show up.
He's standing right by.
He's standing by.
We want to say that one more time for somebody who may be discouraged. Don't be discouraged. Because joy is on the way. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Know that God is nigh.
Stand still. Stand still and look up.
Knowing that God is going to show up. He is standing right by.
He is standing by.
For those of you who may not know it, there's healing.
There's healing for your sorrow.
Woo. There's healing for your pain.
Healing for your pain.
Healing for your spirit. Shelter from the rain.
There's shelter from the rain.
Lord, send the healing.
Lord, send the healing.
Lord, send it for this one thing we know. Six one more time, that there's healing for your sorrow.
There's healing for your sorrow.
Healing for your pain.
Healing for your pain.
Healing for your spirit.
For your spirit.
There's shelter from.
Lord, send the healing.
somebody out there, I hear some sniffling. It must have hit.
Amen.
It must have hit target. Must have hit target. Yeah, glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I thank you. I'm going to share this with you guys. When I do the service and I go before God and I ask Him to give me direction, exactly what videos to utilize in order to minister. Notice what I said, to minister to you all and to minister to the world. And as being one who used to be part of the gospel industry, and actually I had the opportunity to actually serve on the Grammys board here in Washington, D.C. with, we call him the maestro, Richard Smallwood. We used to sit right across from each other. And so I
think, yes, you did.
I thank and praise God for his gifting. Because there are certain songs that come up out of him that will stand the test of time. They're classics. They'll go on forever and ever and ever until the Lord comes. So we thank and praise God for his gifting. Amen. Amen. Matter of fact, I think Pastora's dad actually taught Richard. Is that right? Yeah, because he was at the same school. He used to go to the same school, I think, Pastora went to it in Washington, D.C. But isn't that something? Small world, small world, small world. Well, people, we're going to give you what God has given us on today. We want to thank and praise God that you guys have taken out your time to be a part of the service on today. We do not take you for granted. Pastor and I do not take you for granted. And we believe the Lord has a word for you on today. But before we do all of that, we're going to get started with some prayer. And we're going to go before God and ask Him to send His anointing, first of all, on His manservant, and that you guys will have an ear to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to you on today. Amen?
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Father God, we thank you, Lord Jesus, just for another day. God, yes, we come before you, Lord God, knowing that we are nothing without you, Lord Jesus. Father, we thank you and we praise you just for another day, Lord God. This is your day. And Lord God, we give you the praise and the honor. And we will rejoice in it on today. We thank and we praise you for all things. We ask you, Lord God, to send your word, Lord God, through your handmaiden, through your servant, Lord God, and through all of those who have participated in this service on today, Lord God. Father God, we ask you to hide me, Lord God, behind the cross, Lord God. Lord God, as you speak through me to your people, Lord God, we thank you and we praise you for all things. And we know you're going to have your way in this service and in this word, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Well, first of all, people of God, I want to share with you this title to the message. And I was asking, I said, Lord, what would you have me to say to your people? And he said, son, tell my people, don't lose your joy. With everything that's going on around us, even with our own personal challenges, sometimes we have to remind ourselves that what? That the joy of the Lord is our strength. Notice I didn't say our joy, because our joy is flaky. It's here and it's gone. But the joy of the Lord is our strength. I'm going to go to Nehemiah. We read a little bit of it before, but I'm going to get a little bit more in depth with this. Nehemiah, the 8th chapter, and the 8th verse through the 10th verse. Okay? Nehemiah, the 8th chapter, 8 through 10. And it reads as this. And Nehemiah, which is the Teshephi, which is actually the governor, that's actually what that says, and Ezra, the priest, the scribe, and the Levites that taught the people, said unto all the people, this day is holy unto the Lord your God. Mourn not, nor weep, for all the people wept when they heard the words of the law. 10th verse. Then he said unto them, go your way, eat the fat, drink the sweet, and send portions unto them for whom nothing is prepared. For this day is holy unto our Lord. Neither be ye sorry, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. We see in this particular passage where Nehemiah and Ezra were actually explaining the word of the Lord to the people of God, and they got a little sorrowful because they were thinking in terms of, Lord, we can't live this. This is really when the Ten Commandments and other laws that were given to the people of God, they got a little dismayed. But he told them, notice what he told them. He said, don't get sorrowful. He said, because your joy comes from the Lord. Amen? Amen. Now, let's go over to Psalms 30, and we're going to read the scripture 1 through 5. Psalms 30, 1 through 5. Okay. I will extol thee, O Lord, for thou hast lifted me up and hast made my foes to rejoice over me. O Lord my God, I cried unto thee, and thou hast healed me. O Lord, thou hast brought up my soul from the grave. Thou hast kept me alive, amen, that I should not go down to the pit. Donzie, I was thinking of you when I read that scripture. Amen. Sing unto the Lord, O ye saints of his, and give thanks at the remembrance of his holiness. For his anger endureth but for a moment. Yeah, his anger only endure just for a moment. In his favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Amen. So no matter what you might be going through, it's just a season. It's just a season, child of God. It's just a season, because your joy will come in the morning. The word of God declares that to us. People of God, we're living in a time where there are a lot of folks who are losing their hope in people and in the systems of this world. Therefore, we must remind ourselves, child of God, that we are citizens of the kingdom of God, and that we should never place our trust in man. Somebody say amen. Mm-hmm.
Amen.
We should always remind ourselves that God is our source and he's our resource. People of God, I'm noticing every day that there seems to be more people living on the edge now than ever before. There seems to be a lot of anxiety being manifested in their lives. So the Bible tells us in Philippians 4, 6 through 8, and this is the NIV version, to be anxious for nothing, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. The 7th verse says this, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, the last verse, this 8th verse says, finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, get this now, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think on these things. Amen? However, child of God, there seems to be a real spirit of depression that's very prevalent in the land. I don't know about in other parts of the world. Well, yes, I do too, but I know especially here in the United States. Because of this uneasiness in the faces of people, because of this uneasiness that exists in the world right now, the church must be strong in order to minister to the real needs. Hear what I'm saying, church, to the real needs of the people. We're not necessarily talking about how you're going to get a new Cadillac, a new Mercedes, a new house. Those are not really the real needs. Those are blessings. Those are like the icing on the cake, but those are not the real needs. Amen? Amen.
Amen.
Child of God, the reality is this. Although we are not of this world, we are affected in some ways, whether it be directly or indirectly, by the decisions or policies that are made by our governmental systems, whether it be here in the United States or whether it be in the Philippines, whether it be in Lebanon. We are affected. This is why the Bible tells us that we should pray for our leaders that we may live a peaceful life. Unfortunately, people of God, we have to acknowledge that there is a spirit of anxiousness and confusion that has been released in the atmosphere. And the spirit is spreading throughout the entire world. People of God, let me give you an example of what I'm saying. You say, what are you saying, preacher, though? This is what I'm saying. There are people in this country who are being persecuted for various different reasons to the point that they are seeking, hear me now, they are seeking refuge in churches so they will not be deported back to other countries. Didn't I say it? I say it. You have others who are concerned about losing their health care, or what they call Obamacare, or whatever kind of care you want to call it. They're concerned about losing it. The rate, get this now, the rate of hate crimes are increasingly at an alarming rate. There are Jewish cemeteries being desecrated, and there are Muslim mosques being desecrated and burnt to the ground. These are real issues that some people are facing every day, child of God. Because of this, uncertainties in people's lives, this is robbing their joy. When you got all these things that are going on, all these things that you're facing in your life, that will distract you from what those things that really matter. Unfortunately, they're just kind of going through life, just kind of, you know how we say we just kind of going through the motions? That's exactly what's going on. Therefore, child of God, it is imperative that you and I remind ourselves that the joy of the Lord is our strength. Which takes me to my point one. I want you guys to write this down now. There's a difference. There is a difference between it being happy and being joyful. And I'm going to break it down to you. There's a big difference. And we have to have a clear understanding of that. First of all, child of God, let me make this very clear. God never promised that we would be happy in this life always. He didn't promise that. Matter of fact, the Bible actually says this in Job 14:1, that a man that is born of a woman is of a few days, and they are full of trouble. Child of God, we must understand that happiness, get this now, we must understand that happiness is only for a temporary positive event in our lives. However, the joy of the Lord stems from God Himself, therefore allowing us to experience the joy of the Lord even in the midst of our trials and tribulations. Somebody say amen. Child of God, we must keep in mind, happiness is a fleeting event. It's here today, it's gone tomorrow. I'm going to go a little deeper with that. It's here today, and it can be gone today. Amen. How many times have you had those kind of situations where you got up and you was happy in the Lord and everything was just going wonderful, and then you got a telephone call. And all that happiness and you were just joyful and it all just seemed like it just went right on out the window. That's why we have to focus on God Himself. Okay? Now, like I said, God's joy is permanent. The joy that we may experience will come and go. Now, let me give you these the scripture where it actually will go back to what we were saying before when he was talking in terms of Psalms 30:5 and saying, again, your weeping, it may endure for a night, but your joy will come in the morning. In other words, trouble don't last, child of God. It doesn't last always. It's just but a season. And if we could get that framed in our mind, whatever we may be going through at that particular time, okay, this is going to change. This is not going to be always. This takes me to my point two. Write this down. Satan wants to steal your joy. He wants to steal your joy, your joy, your joy, your joy, my joy. That's his purpose. Child of God, any kind of negative situation that you find yourself in, do not. Somebody say, do not. Do not.
Do not.
Do not. I see you, Elder.
Do not.
Elder Mark. Allow the enemy to steal your joy. I'm going to say that again. Irregardless of whatever negative situation that's going on in your life, do not let the devil steal your joy, because if he can, he will. He knows that if he can steal your joy, He can steal your strength, and guess what? Ultimately, steal your power, as he did with Samson. Mm-hmm. Child of God, no matter what you might be going through, don't give up. Don't give in to your emotions. You know how we can get real emotional about stuff. For the Bible tells us in Romans 12 and 12 to rejoice in the hope, be patient in tribulation, be constant in prayer. Proverbs 10 and 28 says this, tell us that the help of the righteous brings joy, but the expectations of the wicked will perish. People of God, these two scriptures make it very clear, we must not put our trust in man. We must put all our trust and hope in God and Him only, irregardless. Amen. And yes, I'm going to go here, irregardless of who's in the White House or who's in the palace, we must put all our hope and trust in God and in God only. People of God, we are living, and this term is being thrown around a lot here in the United States. We're living in unprecedented times. Even here in the United States, it seems as though we're living in two separate countries because of our politicians, political parties, and various different policies. This country is very divided. We are not the United States. We are the divided states. Now, the Bible tells us in Mark 3:25, it says this, if a house is divided, what does the Bible say? It cannot stand. It cannot stand. Even within the body of Christ. If the body of Christ is divided, it cannot stand. Matter of fact, the Bible tells us that judgment begins in the house of the Lord first. People of God, these are just some of the things that's going on right now in the earth. This is not even taken into account to our own personal challenges that we may face in our everyday lives. The Lord knows that we will have times in our life that we will struggle to keep our joyful spirit. He knows that. And this is the reason why He addressed that in John 15 and 11. Now, I hope you guys are writing these scriptures down. John 15 and 11, He says this, these things I have spoken to you, that my joy may be in you, and that your joy be full. I don't know about you, child of God. I want my joy to be full. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Therefore, in order for these scriptures to manifest themselves in our lives, I must abide in Him, and His Holy Spirit abide in us. This joy that I'm talking about is not of the flesh. It's not of the flesh, but it is a manifestation of the Spirit of God. Now, let me give you something. I'm going to give you something. And she didn't know I was going to do this, but I'm going to do it anyway. When you guys, a couple weeks ago when I was sick, and I was kind of going through, and I woke up that morning, and I was just shaking. And Pastor said, you're going to be okay. Let me give you some more covers. And I kept on shaking. And I said, Lord Jesus, I must have a fever. Because I don't care how much cover I was putting on, it was not. Now I was shaking like a leaf. And yes. Later on, she said to me, and I thought about it after she left. She said, honey, keep telling yourself that you feel better. Keep telling yourself that you feel better. Keep telling yourself that you feel better. And you know how it is, y'all. When you're going through, when you sit, you just like, okay, I'm going to do that in a minute. But right now, I need some Tylenol. I need some aspirin. I need something to help me with these shakes right now. But I thought about that thing later on as I kept speaking. Hear what I'm saying. As I kept speaking to my spirit and bringing that sickness up under the blood of Christ, I started to feel better. What are you saying, preacher? I'm saying as I moved into the presence of God, I felt God's presence coming down and surrounding me. And when you're in the presence of God, things have got to change. They got to change. And as soon as God's presence showed up, then that fever started to break and it left me. I said that to say this. The Lord restored my joy back to me as I moved into His presence, because my joy was gone. So I had to pull on the joy of the Lord. Amen? Amen.
Amen.
Now, I want to talk to you guys in regards to this point three. I want you to write this down, because I want to take the word and make it practical for you. Your praise, now I kind of gave you an example of this actually. Your praise and your prayer helps you to maintain your joy. You have to know what to do when you're going through. Because if you don't, Satan will just have a field day with you. People of God, the joy of the Lord is not only your strength, but also your weapon against the enemy. This is why he tries to steal your joy, because if he can get to you and if he can weaken you, it's easier for him to attack you. However, if your joy remains full in God, it's much harder for him to overtake you. People of God, not only is your joy your weapon against the enemy, but your sincere praise and worship. You know, the Bible talks about he that worship God have to, must, it's not an option. You must worship him in spirit and in truth. There's a lot of praise and worship going on within the body of Christ. I'm not sure if it's even reaching the ceiling. I'm not sure if it's even reaching the ceiling. Because if God's anointing, if God's spirit is not in it, it's not going anywhere. That's why I said sincere praise and worship. It has to exist there in order for it to be effective. In order, get this now, in order for you, in order for your joy to be remain full in you, if you're consistent in your praise and worship, I'm not talking about whenever I get emotional or whenever I feel like it. No, you have to be consistent in your praise and worship. It will yield you a great return when you may be going through a negative situation. It's like this, child of God. You have, you want to draw from the bank of heaven because you have an account there. But notice this, however, if you have not placed anything in your account, you can't withdraw anything out when you need it. Amen? So that praise and worship, you got to be pushing it in. So when you get a little weak in your body, and even weak in the spirit, because we're not always walking in the spirit, we're not always strong all the time. That way you're able to draw from God the fullness of joy that you need in order to get you through. Let me give you an example. I'm gonna give you this is a real example. Pastor and I just went through on last week. We were in the hospital at 3 o'clock in the morning. 3 o'clock in the morning, and as we were sitting there, we had our little mask on because we didn't want to catch any more than what we already had. We encountered a gentleman, Brother Moses. Brother Moses was 82 years old, and as he was sitting there, He was rubbing his knee, and apparently he was having a lot of problems with his knee. As a matter of fact, Don, we were in Northwest, so you know where that was. And yes. We were sitting there, and you know what? He started praying out loud, and he started worshiping God. Didn't he, Pastor? And he kept on talking, and the Spirit of God said, "Watch him, pray for him, pray for him." So I say that to say this. He changed. Notice what I'm saying, child of God. When you start to move into the presence of God, he changed that entire atmosphere. And I say that to say this. Because there was another young lady that was sitting there, was cussing like a sailor, Donzie. Oh, my God. That sister was cussing like a sailor. And I'm sitting there going, Jesus, why is she doing that? You need to be calling on God if you're in this hospital. She was cussing like a sailor. But you know, after Brother Moses got praying, and he was praying for his family, he's praying for his sons and his daughters, and he prayed for us too. And we started interacting and started talking to him, and we started ministering to each other. I could see, I don't know if Pastora saw it, which I know she saw because she sees everything. There were certain people that were in that environment, they started twitching. You know how sin can't stand to be in the presence of God.
The demons, Jesus.
Keep talking about God. They started twitching. They couldn't even sit in the seat. I said, I know what's going on there. I know exactly what's going on there. And then that young lady who was doing all that cussing, that stuff stopped. It stopped. I share that with you guys to let you know that true worship and a true relationship with God can change an entire atmosphere. It can change, and she'll tell you, it changed that entire atmosphere. Because when we first came in there, it was, you could feel it. you could feel what was going on in that hospital. But the presence of God and you interacting with God, no matter where you are, you can change an environment. I don't care if you're at your job, in your homes, at school, or whatever. You can change that atmosphere if the Spirit of God dwells in you. Amen? So, once again, child of God, and I'm pretty much finished. Once again, the Lord wants you and He wants me to know, regardless of what we might be going through, He wants us to totally trust in Him and rely on Him for our resources, not someone else. Child of God, the Bible says this, and I'm going to turn to this because I want to read this. I was reading this the other day, and it really blessed my heart. And you all can go to it if you want. It's 1 Peter. It's 1 Peter 1, 7 through 10. 1 Peter, and it really blessed my heart. 1 Peter 1, 7 through 10. And I'm going to leave you with this scripture, and we'll go on. I'll change up, and then we're going to our communion. 1 Peter 1, 7 through 10. And it says this. Now, I want you to think in terms of yourself as I'm reading this, okay? 1 Peter 1, 7 through 10. That the trial of your faith, being much more precious than of gold, and that perishes, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ, whom having not seen, you love Him. Get this now. Get this. You haven't seen Him, but you still love Him. In whom thou know now. You see Him not, yet believe. You rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory, receiving the end of your faith, even the salvation of your souls, of which salvation the prophets, now get this, the prophets have inquired and searched diligently. In other words, they were looking for this a long time ago. But the Bible says, who prophesied of His grace, that should come unto you. You, and you. Even though you have not seen the Lord. Even though you have not seen the Lord, you still rejoice in the Lord. Even though you have not physically seen the Lord, you still have faith in God. And God honors that. God honors that. Amen? Amen. Amen. So, this portion, I'm done. So, again, child of God, irregardless of what you're going through, do not lose your joy. Do not lose your joy. Okay? Okay? Amen? Amen. 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 We're going to go into our, we're going to go into our communion.
For me.
lose its power. Somebody say the blood still works.
The blood still works.
Amen. Over 2,000 years, the blood is still working. Amen. 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 Well, again, I want to explain to you guys just a very solemn part of the service. And we're going to get through it. And we're going to let you guys go. But again, I want you to really understand this is a very solemn part of the service in regards to your communion. And you to take your communion very seriously. Take your communion very, very seriously. If you have your Bibles, I want you to go to 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter. And I will be reading from the 23rd verse through the 33rd verse. Because I want you to get the full essence. I want you to get the full essence of the communion experience. Amen. First Corinthians, the 11th chapter, 23 through the 33rd, and it reads like this: For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he brake it and said, Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. After the same manner, also he took the cup when he supped, and saying, This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me. For often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he comes. Wherefore, whomsoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But let every man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. For if we judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But if we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with the world. Wherefore, my brethren, when you come together to eat, tarry one for another. We thank God for the reading of his word. Tarry one for another. In other words, wait on each other. Wait on each other. We want to bless these elements. Everybody have their cracker or their bread or their juice. We want to consecrate these elements unto the Lord. Father God, we thank you, Lord God. Lord God, as we lift up the fruit of the vine, Lord God, and the bread, Lord God, representing your death, your burial, and your resurrection. Father, we thank you. We're not even worthy, Lord God, but Lord God, you said according to your word, we're to do this in remembrance of you, Lord God. We thank you and we praise you for what you did for us way back on Calvary over 2,000 years ago. Lord, we thank you and we praise you for that because of your shed blood and all that you did for us. And we praise you and we thank you, Lord God. And we ask you to change these elements, Lord God, into that which is spiritual, Lord God, as we partake of it. And we give you the glory and the honor on today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Okay, I want everyone to take up your bread. And as I give Pastor and Brother Tony theirs. Amen. Amen. All right. People of God, this is the bread. This is the bread that represents the broken body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Let us eat it together. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. People of God, this is the fruit of the vine, which represents the shed blood of Jesus Christ for our sins. Let us all drink together. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Father, we thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Lord, we just thank you. We thank you. Lord, we thank you that you thought enough of us over 2,000 years, Lord God, that you would take on our sins. We thank you. We thank you, Lord God. We thank you for everything that you have done for us and all that you're doing for us. Lord God, we ask you, Lord God, to bless this body of believers, Lord God. Continue to bless them from the east to the west, Lord God. Every home, every family that is represented on today, Lord God, we ask a special anointing, Lord God, on each one of their lives, that you may use them to your glory. Elder Mark, are you still there? Because I saw him pop in. But if not, I want to say again, you are there. Elder Mark, could you give us the benediction? But I want to say, I appreciate you guys' faithfulness and all that you guys are doing over there in the Middle East and lifting up the name of Jesus. I praise God for you. I was sharing with Evangelist Malagos, and also Sister Grace was in my heart, because I like to start a work there in the Philippines at EagleM International Church. And we believe in that. We believe in that. That's going to happen. We are believing that. That's, I don't know how it's going to happen, but I know Sister Wendy and Brother Freddie going to be going home soon. They're going to be going back to the Philippines. So maybe that's how it'll start. Amen. 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 What I always tell you guys, each one, reach one, right? And that's how it starts. And Donzie, I haven't forgotten about Connecticut too. I haven't forgotten about Connecticut. So we thank and praise God for all things. Elder Mark, going to give us the benediction, and I praise God for you guys. I praise God for your faithfulness. Again, continue to pray for Pastor and Pastor and my family here. Tony, you don't see Tony, but Tony's doing all the operating, which takes a lot off of me. It helps me to focus. So I praise God for him. He don't know he's going to be my junior deacon soon. He just don't know it yet. Y'all see how he's looking at me. But God is good. God is good. God is good. God is good, and God is great. And he's good all the time. Elder Mark?
Yes, I am.
Go and give us the benediction, my brother. Yes, see if you can find it.
Heavenly Father, in the name of your Son, Jesus, we thank you for all that has been said and done this day unto your glory. You have said in your word, where two or three are gathered together in your name, there you are in the midst of them. You have shown yourself to be of every present help in the time of trouble. And we bless your name because without you, we can do nothing. In you, we live, we move, and we have our being. And Lord, we thank you for the word. We thank you, oh God, for this service. Lord, bless Pastor Virgil, Lady India, Lord, Pastor India. Bless every soul that is on this telecast on today. Bless their families.
Yes, God.
That you have a mighty upon them. Yes, use them for your holy benefit. Oh God, that your name would be glorified in the words, actions, and thoughts of your people. Lord, we pray even on today that you will bless those who will tune into this service.
Yes, God.
Those who may view the replay, give them a special blessing.
Yes, God.
Something and in need of. Lord, we bind the hand of the enemy
in the name of Jesus.
To feel our joy, our peace, and our standing in you.
Hallelujah.
Oh, God.
Yes,
Father God.
Glory.
Today,
it's another time. Lord, yeah, God.
The hand and the strategy.
Yes, God.
Oh God, we arrest, we revoke
His
power and authority.
Yes.
And we loose, oh God, your power to do greater things
yes,
in our lives.
Greater things
the area,
for you,
the regions that we live in.
Yes.
Remember, O God, our various employers, our various governmental
yes.
leaders,
yes.
and our spiritual leaders.
Yes.
In the mighty
yes.
Jesus.
Bless their employers, God. Bless their
in
homes.
Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Elder Mark. Thank you all, Brother Freddie. You guys finally got in there. Praise God for you. I was a little worried. I said, man, I got all the sisters. Where my brothers at? But praise God. We're glad you guys were able to come in. And like I said, you guys continue to pray. Continue to pray for Pastor. You know, the devil's been trying to. Y'all know she was having her own little church. She was having her own little church a couple hours ago. She was in the back room and she was getting her shout on. So she already had church a couple times a day. Amen. So we praise God for you guys. I love you guys. We love you with the love of the Lord. Continue to stay strong. Continue to stay strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. And real soon, we're going to have Evangelist Malagros going to give us a word, and we're going to have Evangelist Donzie going to give us a word. So y'all might as well start. You might as well start preparing yourself now. I'm just letting you know, I'm serving notice on this day. God says, prepare yourself. I don't want to hear no excuses. And God don't want to hear no excuses. So I'm telling you now, prepare yourself to give a word. You were blessed on today with the service on today. I tell you, it was a blessed time. We had a good time in the Lord. All my sisters and brothers there in Lebanon and Saudi Arabia and other parts of the Middle East, we praise God for you guys. We praise God for your faithfulness. Pastor and I love you in the Lord. And all our different members that are following us throughout the world, we praise God for you. We don't take anybody for granted. We want you to continue to keep us in prayer. And we also pray that you are also blessed by the communion on today, that the Lord will bless you real good. Continue to keep us in your prayers and continue to strive and be all that God has called you to be. Be blessed of the Lord.